It's just a wonderful morning to see you all here. This is the first event of its kind, LGBT caregiving and Alzheimer's. And I'm just thrilled that we're doing this today. I'm honored to be a small part of it. But I'm especially here this morning to introduce Senator Leno, Mark Leno, who has been a longtime supporter of all LGBT issues, but is especially thoughtful and supportive of issues around Alzheimer dementia care. Senator Leno.
Thank you, Marcy. Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
What an impressive gathering. It really is an idea whose time has come, and we want to thank Marcy Edelman for her years and years of visionary leadership, not only for our community as a whole, but also for senior care, of course, her leadership at Open House. We go back nearly 15 years or so when she called me to say, Mark, we need some senior housing for our community. And we went off to see Art Agnos, who was then the director of HUD for this part of the country. And Art held our hands, and Marcy just led the way, and we've come so far since then. And also, of course, thanks to Melon McBride for your leadership as well, Melon, and bringing us all together. Over 220, maybe pushing 230 caregivers, care partners, advocates, healthcare providers are all assembled here today to deal with the very daunting but real challenges of LGBT dementia, caregiving, and awareness. And as you know, probably better than I, the issues are very complex. Probably not a degree or two of separation among each of us in knowing someone who has dealt with dementia in one form or another. For those of us who will reach the age of 85, and this is in the general community, one out of two will have some form of dementia. That's just stunning and is going to really be a major challenge to us as a nation as we age and as we live longer if we don't get our arms around this sooner rather than later. And it's been encouraging to hear President Obama talk about federal funding. We have to find a better understanding of what causes this so we can find some kind of cure, if not prevention. All of the tens of billions of dollars we've invested in cancer research and AIDS research, quite appropriate, but we're doing just a tiny little fraction for issues around dementia, and that has to change, or we'll all pay a very great price for it. So I'm just here to say welcome and to say thank you for your commitment, for your determination, for your tenacity, for your passion, and for your compassion. My family dealt with my mother's Alzheimer's for about 10 years. She died coming up on 3 years ago, later this month. And she was very fortunate through it all, and we were all very fortunate through it all. Number one, a loving and supportive family. And as horrible, horrible as the disease was and is for so many, she turned into a ball of love in her final months and years. And I'm certain it's because of the love and support that she was surrounded by. And in many ways, I think the individual with Alzheimer's or dementia maybe just reflects whatever the surrounding environment might be. And to the degree that we can be there for each other, we've always been, as an LGBT community, self-reliant and resourceful out of our nature and as a result of our circumstances. We've always looked out for each other. We've been through epidemics before, and we're going to get through this together as well. So congratulations in assembling this first of its kind. And on a final word, because what we can accomplish as a community and as a state, not a nation, always depends on resources. Sometimes it's good to be budget chair, and I am chair of the budget committee for the Senate this year, as I was for last year. We've been through some rough times, of course, as a result of the economic global crisis, which began in 2008, but we're now in a fifth year of recovery, economic recovery and expansion. And one relatively small line item in a $113 billion general fund budget is for caregiver resource centers. And these centers, which are throughout the state, provide services for caregivers and other family non-paid caregivers to help them and to be a support for them. That line item got cut by 74% in 2009, from around $10.5 million down to $3 million. And I'm going to be working with Marcy and Melon and others, and I appreciate any kind of feedback you can give our office, because if we have even a million or two, maybe three, to begin to reinvest, where would be the best investment? Where will we get the greatest return on our dollar? If it's in the community resource centers, caregiver resource centers, well, then maybe we should fight for that. Every million will be a battle. We've got a very tight-fisted governor. We love him, but he's got to get a little looser with the nickel, if you ask me. It's time to reinvest in the people of California, not keep putting more and more money into reserve funds and paying down debt. We can do that, and at the same time, begin to address the needs of Californians. Thank you for being here, and have a very successful day.